Welcome to JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals. I'm Jamie Scott Okataya of JSA, here at ITW 2019 in Atlanta. Joining me here today, the man of the hour, I should say, everyone's talking about Peder Naerbo, who is the founder and chairman of Bulk Infrastructure, a brand that you need to know if you don't already, Bulk Infrastructure. Peder, welcome to JSA TV.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
We are honored to have you, and sustainability is on the minds of many here at ITW today. Tell us, how are you so focused on sustainable solutions?
Well, I see the world has two mega trends right now. One is the digitalization, and the other one is the climate crisis that we're going into. And of course, in the middle of this, you have a massive growth of data center capacity that grows throughout the world. And bulk infrastructure, we want to be part of the solution rather than talk about the problem. Everybody knows the problem of using dirty energy to feed the power into the data centers. So we want to unlock the Nordic region where we have a massive amount of surplus of renewable energy for the data center industry to grow.
Amazing. So you talk about the five C's. Tell us more.
Yeah, so this is clean clouds and contents cross-connected. So this is where we want to have places throughout where people can jump on board and go into a network system supported by our own systems and also partners to bulk infrastructure, where we can bring them to the Nordics to utilize the great potential the Nordic has.
And that's a perfect transition, actually, into the Nordic Gateway, talking about unlocking that clean energy, the Nordic region. Tell us a little bit about the Nordic Gateway. I know it's a big story that just hit the news wires here at ITW.
Yeah, so we have launched the Nordic Gateway to be an on-ramp where people can meet the networks that are within the Nordic region. So first of all, the first place we are launching is the NJFX, or New Jersey Fiber Exchange, in Walden, New Jersey. So this is for the U.S. market to go straight into the Nordic region. And as they offer to their clients opportunities to travel to and from Europe, Nordics is going to be a part of the discussion. And we will make it simple to be an infrastructure provider where you just meet us at the NJFX, and we will take care of whatever proposal you need on capacity or dark fiber within Europe to go into the Nordics.
So exciting, and that's on that Havfrue cable that we just mentioned, actually, in our NJFX interview here also at ITW. So wonderful correlation there. Why did and how does one go about choosing a partner like NJFX?
Well, it's for us, it was a great opportunity when the Havfrue cable was under designing, because it was the first cable to go into the North Sea between the UK and the Nordic region in 20 years. So, and being a transatlantic cable. So for us, it was not obvious, I think, to Google and Facebook that we would jump on board that cable system, because we were, an unknown participant in the Nordic region. But we saw it as very important to bring this cable to Norway in particular, and also into Denmark, and be part of that development, so that we can bring that Nordic region into the U.S. market. And then, of course, as the cable lands in Walden, New Jersey, it was quite obvious for us to see that we didn't want to travel on into different regions. We want people to meet us at a place where we already have a data center with capacities on data center and the T3 security and so on. So you can get professional services right there. And for us, it's important not to go into the U.S. market. We want to be an infrastructure provider, so we just want to hand off or pick up our customers at the building.
Right. That's an important sort of carrier neutrality that you bring to the table, if you will.
Absolutely, absolutely. And equally, we are in Norway and Denmark. We are building similar facilities, so the customers can have the same opportunity also in the European side.
And there's also such a huge move today, especially in the subsea space, of these OTTs coming into our space and building it with our partnerships. And that sort of leads me to your announcement with Amazon.
Yep.
Can you tell us a little bit more there?
Well, it's not much to tell. They have already pointed to the cold north and the cold and wet north, I would say. So they're already, you know, building large sites in Sweden. Mm-hmm. And we also see, as they travel on our network into the Nordic region, we hope that also brings other opportunities. So they're also coming into our carrier neutral facilities in Denmark and Norway. So that's the opportunity, I think, that they have grasped. It's not us telling them to go to Nordics, but we're trying to make the large-scale digital infrastructure become sustainable. And I think the hyperscalers are the proof of that, because you will find both, not only Amazon, but you'll find Google, Facebook, and Apple are all very much scaling into the Nordic region.
And it makes sense. Again, cold, wet, and clean. So the Nordic Gateway, absolutely exciting news on the news desks here at ITW. Thank you so much, Peder, for joining us today. And thank you, viewers, for tuning in to JSA TV here at ITW. Happy networking.